Well, hey family, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a minute, but I'm back now. And if you already read the title, then you know what we're getting into today. So today's video is going to be my little morning routine vlog. I know it's dark, that's because it's about 7:50 in the morning. I haven't really cut on the lights. But Kaylin is woke now. I'm about to get ready to make breakfast. Well, change her diaper, get her personal hygiene together, and then I'm gonna make breakfast and we'll go from there. So I just wanna take y'all along with me so y'all can see what I do in the morning when we first get up. So I just changed her diaper, got her a bottle, cleaned her room up. As y'all can see, I just strained it up for the day because she gonna mess it up 35 million more times. And then in the morning, she just chills like this or in the middle of the floor and watch her Minnie Mouse or whatever is on Disney Channel at the moment. Now I'm about to put some sausages in the air fryer so that they can go ahead and start getting done so I can get her some breakfast, and I'm gonna go work on my personal hygiene. So normally for breakfast, I cook me two sausages and cook Kaylin just one, but she don't need all that. And plus, even still, she eats her breakfast, and once she's done with her breakfast, she comes and eats mine with me. So I know cooking her two or three sausages would have been too much because she wouldn't eat it all while she's alone. She would literally have to be in my presence to eat that much food. She's not gonna do that while she's sitting alone. So I just make her one and I make myself two. And normally if Tay is here, I'll make him two as well. But he gonna work, so. What you doing, Mom? The bacon bits fell out on me when I just opened up the cabinet. That's because last night, y'all, I cooked some bomb ass steaks, honey. Excuse my moo-moo. Y'all know I don't have on no bra and it's early in the morning, but I cooked some bomb ass steak last night, y'all, and it was so good. Tay ate two pieces. That's how I know it was good, because he is very picky about his food, y'all. And he ate more than one piece, so that's how I know that the steak was good, baby. We had steak, baked potatoes, and garlic bread. And I cooked the steaks in the oven. I pan-seared them on the stove, and then I popped them in the oven for like 30 minutes and cooked them. Let me know in the comment section below if y'all want my recipe on how I did them things, y'all. They were so good, and I can't wait because I got some more. These the kind I use. The beef boneless eye of ground steak. This is the one I used last night. Amazing. And actually, I think I'm about to take these out of the freezer because it say keep refrigerated, and I don't want them to freeze, and then once I throw them out, it take all that juice and that flavor out. So if I don't take it out today and put it in there just for safekeeping before I get ready to cook it, or in advance, instead of thawing it out in water, I'm gonna just pop it in the fridge the day before, and then the day of, it won't take that long to thaw out, and that way I probably won't lose as much flavor. But yeah, those steaks was good, and I got those from Kroger. So if y'all have a Kroger in y'all neighborhood or in y'all area, go check them out. And then they was $7 with my grandma Kroger Plus card. So y'all can't beat that. Initially, they was what, like $9 or $10? I think the pack that we ate last night was priced at $11, but I ended up getting it at $7 because my grandma used my Kroger Plus card. So y'all take advantage of them because the steaks is nice and they're affordable. We had it with some good old steak sauce. Plain. It was good. It was good. I actually like doing this vlog in the morning because in the morning time, y'all, normally my grandma texts me when I first get up. But other than that, I don't be having nobody to talk to in the morning because Tay leave for work at like 7:30, 7:45. So it just be me and Kayla here. And Kayla can't really understand what I'm saying and interact with me. And I know y'all can't interact with me either, but it still makes me feel more comfortable and content talking to somebody and knowing that eventually somebody is going to hear me. So, yeah. I appreciate y'all for that, sticking around with me. Go ahead and make these, well, mix these eggs. Okay, so y'all, real quick. I put this in one of my videos, this coat of skin. If y'all have not heard of Coat of Skin yet, I suggest y'all look into it. It is amazing. After I had Kaylin, I had really, really, really bad hormonal acne around my jaw area, like on this side, as well as down here and like on my neck. I had a couple of bumps right here, but it was mainly down here in these areas. It's like I had start growing a freaking beard. And you know, people shave and they get those little bumps. That's what it looked like, but it wasn't that. It was acne and it was itching so bad. It was itching every single day. I got this Coat of Skin, y'all, and I promise you, the first day I used it, I seen results. No lie. Get Coat of Skin, y'all. I got the whole bundle. I got the cleanser, the toner, and the moisturizer. The only thing I think I don't have is the under eye pads because I don't need those. But get some Coat of Skin on Instagram. They at name is at Coat of Skin, y'all. At Coat of Skin. And if you can't find them on there, I think the owner name is B. Marie. Look into it, y'all. I'm telling y'all, it's good. Good stuff. Okay, y'all, so I just took a shower, did my hygiene, straightened up my room and stuff like that. And so now I'm about to come in and finish making breakfast, cook the eggs and stuff like that, like I was telling y'all. And I know I still look kind of rough. I know you like, girl, you took a shower and put on a nightgown. That's because those of y'all who know me know I stay in the house most of the time because I work and go to school from home. So it's rare that we leave. So while I'm resting around the house, I don't bother putting on no real clothes like that every single day. So today we just chilling. We do have errands to run, but that's later on in the day and I'll be done put on clothes by then. But for now, while we just chilling around the house, this is my get up. She real funny acting, y'all. She real funny acting. So I got these cute, well, my mama got her these cute little bowls. It came in a set, so it comes with the different color bowls, different color plates with placemats, and the plain plates with different colors, as well as cups. And y'all can get those from, if y'all have kids or something, nieces and nephews, y'all can get those from Walmart. They have them for like $5. My grandma got those for her first move. So that's what she eats out of. And then once I get her breakfast plated and everything, I'll show y'all how we do the feeding process. So right now I'm just cutting up her waffle because most of her food does have to be cut in order for her to eat it, not properly, but efficiently. Because if I give it to her in clumps, well, like if I give her this whole waffle like this, she's gonna bite and nibble off of it, but majority of it is gonna go to waste because it's so big, it overwhelms her. So what I do is I just cut it up in little small pieces like that, you know, so that she able to pick it up and hold it and feed herself. But making sure that she also gets a decent amount of food, a good serving amount. For her sausage, I do the same thing. I cut it up. And then if it's still smoking or hot, I take it and I just sit it in the freezer for a little while just so it can cool off until I get her table situated. Okay, as you can see, this is her breakfast. We got some waffles, some sausage, and some cheese eggs. So now I'm about to go ahead and take it to her. And this is where she sits. The camera focus. This is where she sits during breakfast. She sits here and watches her cartoons. She watching Bluey right now. So yeah, on Disney Junior. So this is what she does. Mommy, why you keep coughing like that? You getting sick? You need medicine? Okay, so now that I got Kaylin all situated and together, I got breakfast situated and together, I straightened up, cleaned up, all that stuff. It's 9:13, and what I normally do around this time, once I get a chance to sit after I do my motherly duties, I check my homework, what I have due for today or, you know, the day after, just to see, you know, just to stay aware of my course load, because, you know, I don't want to get behind on school because it is my senior year of college. I begin my associate's degree in business management and administration. So I'm trying to stay up on my game, y'all. So I do this every single morning just so I can make sure that I'm not missing any assignments. So in the morning when I log on my portal, my Blackboard portal, this is what I see. So basically all of these right here are my classes that I'm currently enrolled in. And then I can go down here and check my calendar and see what I have due. So there's 18th. It says I don't have anything, but I'm going to go back and double check because like I said, sometimes the assignments can be hidden. So far, so now I'm gonna go check my email and see if my teachers email me any announcements that I need to see. And yeah, then we're gonna go ahead and enjoy the rest of my morning. Checking my email, like I said, I don't have really nothing. This lighting in my bedroom is amazing. Check it out. Okay, y'all. So now that I know I don't have no workload for today, I don't have any work. But I, other than the errands that I do have to run a little bit later on in the afternoon, I am about to go ahead and go to my next step of my morning routine. She's finished. The girl is finished, y'all, with her breakfast. So,
Yeah, so now that she's done, I'm gonna go ahead and just take this in the kitchen. And she normally just plays, y'all. She just does her own thing, y'all. That's one thing I can say about Kaylin. She's very self-sufficient. She's very independent. She plays great by herself. I don't really have to have, I don't have no problems out of her, really. Other than her thinking that my house is a jungle gym. She climbs up on everything. Everything, y'all. She climbs up on the sofas. She climbs on my end tables, on my center table. She climbs up on anything that she could climb up on. In her room, I know that y'all notice she has a dresser in there, the little white dresser that her TV sits on. She climbs up on that. One time she climbed up on there and ended up slipping and falling, and she had a really, really bad bruise on her chin. I was so upset because she finna do it now. Hold on. Let me see if I can catch her on camera. Are so good for babies. Kayla love them. After she eats breakfast and she's playing and doing all that, what I would do is take some and sit it right here on her table in front of her television, so that while she's playing and moving around, if she wants a snack, it can be within reach. Come on. Oh yeah, Obama runs, y'all. Why? Alright, y'all, so after I finished rolling up, as y'all seen, I'm just sitting in my living room now about to watch some First 48 and chill out. Y'all, when I tell y'all I can literally sit and watch First 48 all freaking day, I can sit and watch it all day, because that's what I do, sit and watch it all day. If it's not First 48, Law & Order, SVU, or Paternity Court, or Couples Court, or YouTube, baby, I don't watch it. I'm sorry. I tried to get into Love & Hip Hop, as y'all seen, and do the little reviews, but honestly, I think I should have got in on it during the earlier seasons, because now Love & Hip Hop is going down the drain. It's no longer good. It's not even Love & Hip Hop Atlanta anymore. It's Love & Hip Hop USA, because they have people on there from all different franchises. And I don't like that. It's not giving me that authentic Atlanta feel. I'm not here for Erica Mena and Safari and they foolish ass storyline. I'm not here for Rashida. I'm not here for none of them hoes, honestly. Bambi and them big ass gums, I'm not here for it. I honestly never liked her and Scrappy together in the first place. I feel like all she do is nag, 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 nag. Scrappy is still a mama's boy. He's gonna always be a mama's boy, even though he love his kids. And I love that he love his kids. Who else? Sierra with all them damn feelings in her face. She giving scammer vibes, even though I know she making her money. You just giving off this weird vibe now all of a sudden, and I don't like it. I kind of want her and Shooter to get back together, even though he's a cheating ass lying dog. But y'all, I'm just over loving hip hop. I can't. That's why I just stick to the rivers and the lakes that I'm used to. And First 48 ain't never failed me. If y'all want me to do some First 48 reviews, let me know, because I will do it. I will do some First 48 reviews for y'all. I will. It's different and nobody else on YouTube is doing it right now from what I know. So if y'all like First 48 like I like it, and y'all want me to do some reviews on it, let me know and I will. I'll do it. I'll get that started for y'all. I just got to figure out how I will go about doing it. Okay, y'all, so I'm recording it here because the lighting is better, but I'm about to go ahead and finish my blunt, eat breakfast, and then go run my errands. So that's the end of this vlog, y'all. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Comment down below if y'all want more content like this. Comment down below some story time ideas, as well as let me know if y'all do want me to go ahead and get started on those First 48 reviews. Like I mentioned before, be sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I will see each and every one of y'all in my next video. Peace out.